recharge headset.
Batteries. They allow us to be mobile for a little bit, but at the end of the day, you still gotta plug it. What if we could ditch wires entirely? What if we could just beam power to this thing through the air and power things that way? Well, it'd make things like headphones, smartphones, and laptops a lot more convenient. For factories with thousands of sensors and IoT devices, it'd be more than convenient. It would save them millions in infrastructure costs. And if we could scale this technology up to beaming power across hundreds or thousands of kilometers, it could completely change the way that we generate and distribute energy. And the most exciting thing is that wireless electricity will probably become widespread in the next 10 years. So here's how it works and what that will look like. Sending and receiving electricity through the air is actually nothing new. Your router generates a radio wave from an antenna, for example, which gets picked up by the antenna in your phone and converted into electrical signals. Wireless power transmission works in a very similar way, with a transmitting element and a receiving element sending and receiving radio waves between each other. The difference is that transmitting elements need to output at much higher power levels to be useful, and they need to output beams that are precisely targeted at receivers, instead of uniformly radiating out their energy. At room scale, that's exactly what companies like Guru and Osia have figured out how to do. Guru uses a proprietary smart lensing technology to transmit beams directly from a hub to devices in the room. Osia provides a similar solution, but at a different frequency, and they don't require line of sight. These kind of systems have all sorts of applications in home, work, and industrial environments. And these technologies are right on the cusp of commercial application. Osia got FCC certification last year, and Guru just days ago signed a deal with Motorola to integrate its technology into Motorola's mobile devices. Transmitting power over longer distances is tougher. Beams can be shaped using phased arrays, but due to diffraction, antennas have to get larger and larger as distance increases. To transmit power efficiently over 100 kilometers, for example, you would need transmitting and receiving antennas each over 100 meters in diameter. New Zealand company Emrod solves this problem by creating passive relays that shape microwaves in between antennas to allow them to travel further without diffraction loss. Using this technology, they're hoping to build power grids that are half the price of traditional power grids and can be quickly deployed for situations like disaster relief. Another approach being explored by the Naval Research Laboratory is to use light and lasers instead of microwaves. Although lasers and photovoltaic receivers are much less efficient than microwave antennas, they have the key advantage of having a much shorter wavelength, allowing them to suffer less diffraction loss and transmit power over longer distances with much smaller hardware. Lastly, the holy grail of wireless power transmission is space solar power, an idea where solar power is generated in space and then beamed down wirelessly to the Earth. Solar power is way more intense and way more consistent in space than it is on the surface of the Earth under the atmosphere, so it's a really compelling renewable energy source. As with before, the main challenge is size. A satellite in orbit would need an antenna a kilometer in diameter in order to beam power efficiently to the surface of the Earth. This seems crazy, and in 1970 it was. It was estimated that it would take upwards of $250 billion to launch a single plant into orbit. But we've come a long way since then. In 2018, Caltech unveiled a thin foldable design that placed solar panels and antenna transmitters back to back. It could weigh as little as 160 grams per square meter and be deployed in just a few dozen launches. In January this year, an Australian company laid out plans to create a structure that would assemble itself in space based off of designs by NASA engineer John Mankins. They plan to have a pilot in orbit by 2026 and have a functional plant by 2029. The US Air Force has been in on the action too. They're currently building an experimental satellite that they're planning to launch in 2024. Space solar power at the moment is still kind of elusive. It's only really affordable for big militaries and big governments to take on. But remember that GPS started off as a military technology too before becoming ubiquitous. With space launch costs going down and technologies like in-space manufacturing being developed, it'll probably only be a matter of time before the first space solar power plant is operational. In conclusion, applications of wireless power transmission range from the everyday to the visionary, but it's upon us, so get ready for a day when these things are obsolete.